Shalom, shalom, women of the living word. Shalom, shalom, mishpacha. It is Hephtsibah bringing you greetings as we bring the Shabbat to a close here in Florida. I'm in northern Florida in the panhandle, and I just wanted to stop in and bring you greetings since it's been a while since I've checked in. I also wanted to let you know some of the exciting things that we have on the horizon for women of the living word. We will have a website and blog launching soon, and also wanted to let you know that we will have a guide, a preparation guide for you coming forward for Pesach, which is the first moed of the year, the first appointment of the year. That will be available for you in digital download and hopefully also a hardcover as well. The preparation guide, as well as the Haggadah, which is the book that you use to do the telling of the Passover story for those who will be hosting in their homes and also for the community. And so I wanted to let you know that Women of the Living Word has had that project being prepared in the spirit for some time now, and we look forward to its completion and time for observance this Pesach. Women of the Living Word will be observing Pesach this year on the evening of April 13th to the evening of April 14th, followed immediately by unleavened bread, Hagmatzah, on the evening of the 14th. We will be observing matzah, unleavened bread, from April 14th through April 21st. And again, we will begin our observance of Pesach on the evening of the 13th of April. So again, the dates are for the entire Moed of Passover of Pesach, the evening of the 13th through the 21st of April. I also wanted to let you know that we will have a live reading, or at least a recorded reading, of Hosea for your enrichment in the coming days. And also we'll be doing a reading of the Megillah, the scroll for the Feast of Purim, the Minor Feast of Purim, I should say, or observance of Hadassah, Esther. And as is customary for my home, we will do a three-day fast, breaking that fast with the Minor Feast of Purim, Hadassah, in preparation of the heartwork for observance of Pesach. And so I just wanted to let those who would want to join in Haruach know that that will be coming forward for this group and some of the things that you can expect there. So stay tuned. Without further ado, I wanted to get into a reading from Tehillim, Psalm 16, for your enrichment tonight, and to say goodbye to the Shabbat as the sun is setting here. Guard me, O El, for I have taken refuge in you. I have said to Yahuwah, you are Yahuwah. I have no good beside you. As for the set-apart ones who are on the earth, they are the excellent ones in whom is all my delight. The sorrows of those who run after another are increased. I would not pour out their drink offerings of blood, nor take up their names on my lips. Yahuwah is the portion of my inheritance and my cup. You uphold my lot. Boundary lines have fallen to me in pleasant places. Indeed, a good inheritance is mine. I bless Yahuwah, who has given me counsel. My kidneys also instruct me in the nights. I have set Yahuwah always before me, because he is my right hand, and I am not shaken. Therefore my heart was glad, and my esteem rejoices. My flesh also dwells in safety, for you do not leave my being in the grave. Neither let your kind one see corruption. Show me the path of life. In your presence is joy to satisfaction. At your right hand are pleasures forever. Abba, we thank you for the reading and the hearing of your word. We ask that it would bring forth fruit. We thank you for giving us your Torah and sustaining us in your Torah, for setting us apart by your commandments. We thank you, Abba Yah, giver of the Torah. Bless those who you have blessed, keep those who you have kept, and we thank you, Abba, that no one is able to snatch us out of your mighty right hand. And with this, I will bring it to a close. B'Shem Yahusha, Halal Yahuwah. Amen.